Hey, what's up, everybody? Hope everybody's doing all right. Thank you so much for tuning in. It's greatly appreciated. And well done on surviving 1 year under the lockdown. Just a quick question. Am I buffering for everybody else or is it just me? Just first off the bat, because YouTube doing fantastic work again in streamlining everything so that people can watch. Am I buffering or am I smooth or what's going on? Okay, I'm fine. Well, that's good, because on my side, it's like it's not looking too good. Let me know if I start buffering so that I can check it out. Okay. Anyway, happy 1 year anniversary, ladies and gentlemen, of the lockdown. Now, most of you will obviously know that it has been 365 days of a lockdown that was supposed to be only 21 days, technically. But we all know the ANC, and this is probably in their time day 7 of the 21 days of lockdown. So yeah, happy 1 year lockdown anniversary. And as you can see, this is a fail Pepsi because it's got that rim to it. Cheers. Cheers, everybody. Ah, fatay no lekker. Fatay lekker. By the way, do all of you remember this? just for the record, do all of you remember this gem? Remember when we were all quite nervous and not sure what was going to happen? Remember this? Remember this one? Let's have a listen.
As a consequence, the National Coronavirus Command Council has decided to enforce a nationwide lockdown for 21 days with effect from midnight on Thursday, the 26th of March. This is a decisive measure to save lives of South Africans from infection and save the lives of hundreds of thousands of our people. While this measure will have a considerable impact on people's livelihoods, mm-hmm. on the life of our society and on our economy, the human cost of delaying this action would be far, far greater.
Yeah. 21 days, ladies and gentlemen. 21 days. That stream took place on the 23rd of March, 2020. And here we are now 365 days later, and we are in lockdown level 1. So 365 days of our rights being taken away from us, where we have been, we've been in a state of disaster now for a year. Which tells you one of two things. Either this virus is the most dangerous thing that South Africa has ever faced, or we've got an incompetent government that did not make sure that the healthcare system was up to scratch and that the country was ready to face this pandemic. So it's one of those two options. Which one was it? I want to know from all of you. All of you watching, I want to know. What was it? Was it the incompetence of the ANC, or was it one of the biggest natural disasters that we have faced as a country? Let me know. How's it to everybody, by the way, that has tuned in? By the way, as promised tonight, this pillow will be auctioned off. I've had this pillow for, I think, like 6, 7, 8 years. This was what I got from YouTube when I was like at 20,000 something odd subscribers. This was the only thing other than that 100,000K plaque that I received from YouTube. So I'm giving this away to the top super chat tonight. This is a legitimate YouTube pillow, even though it doesn't have anything that says YouTube on it other than the subscribe. And then it's got a Carter bite mark over there and a couple of Kennedy bite marks there closer to the play button. So the big one is Carter and then the rest. And then it says subscribe on it. And I'm not sure if this is a shit mark at the back here. No, it smells nice. It smells alright still. So the top super chat tonight will get this. Currently in the lead is Alfred Want. Congratulations. If in the by the end of this hour you are the top super chat, then you get this. But this is like my pillow that has been in the back of my live streams and a lot of my videos for a very, very long time. So I'm giving this away. The other thing that YouTube gave me that you can have if you are the top super chat of the evening. For now, I'll just use it to rest my elbows on. Love the new plaque. Well, thank you very much. I hope it doesn't dawn it off. I've used Gorilla double-sided tape and I've put it on. I didn't drill holes into my wall because that will be just stupid. So yeah, if that falls off, it's going to like definitely break and cause some massive damage. So let's hope that the Gorilla tape lasts and that that stays there. So yeah, anyway, so it's been 1 year. 1 year. I wonder, there was this other thing that I wanted to check quickly while we at it.
Right? The nationwide lockdown will...
Shut up! We heard enough about you. We heard enough about you. Let me just do this one thing quick here. Just give me a second. Let me take the brightness down a bit because it's so bright. The other thing... Oh, wow. Here comes the super chats. Mario, thank you for upgrading for renewing your membership. That's greatly appreciated. Thank you, honorable member. It is greatly appreciated. And then Ursula gave a 35 Rand super sticker, which means that Ursula is in the lead. This looks... there we go. I look less pale, but like it looks better. So Ursula is in the lead. And then as I say that, Mario Pistorius just came with 50 Rand saying, I wear an old hose. I wear, Mario. So sorry, Ursula. But Mario is now in the lead with 50 Rand for the subscribe pillow. That I am not washing. My beard hair will be on here. I'm not going to wash it because I don't want to spend much more money on it. So yeah. So, by the way, are you guys drinking? Are you having a braai? Are you at least having some fun? You know, is there something at least that's going on your side that you are celebrating this 1 year anniversary of lockdown? Be sure to smash that like button if you haven't yet. And also, please be sure to subscribe. Keep me above 100,000 because otherwise I'll have to post that thing back to YouTube if I jump below 100,000. Swadim DJ says, I've bought a new TV. Well, that's nice. I hope it's like a nice and big TV, like a 65-incher or more. Alfred Wand says, ach nee, julle suck. Because what? Like your bid was Alfred Wand. Sorry, man. Sorry, Alfred Wand. Like you almost already have like a piece of my hair and some stuff that like I threw away in my trash that you went through. Surely. Carl says, I'm having a beer. Well, there we go. I came here for fun. Well, yeah. 1 year. 1 year, ladies and gentlemen. 1 year. And remember, in that 1 year, you weren't allowed to buy cigarettes for a long period of time. You weren't allowed to buy alcohol for a long period of time. You weren't allowed to move freely. You weren't allowed to go and exercise. And you weren't allowed to go to the beach or go to open parks. All of that in the last 365 days. And this year we've got an election coming up. So I wonder if the people are going to punish the government that gave us this. A bunch of people saying they're having some booze. Well, that's good. I think we're halfway through our lockdown. I really honestly believe that we are halfway through our lockdown. So, I don't know. Do you guys think that lockdown's going to end anytime soon? I think that we are, like, technically halfway through it. I mean, if the United States could have had an election during there during the pandemic, then surely we can have one too. So I don't know. Cameron says, I'm having some lacquer Pepsi. Well, I'm having a fail Pepsi. Lacquer. Lacquer ochate. Reese says, hey Ronaldo and Menzies. Hello Reese, dankie dat jy ingeskakel het. I appreciate it. It's a Saturday and we are celebrating the 1 year anniversary of lockdown. Lockdown. 1 year. Een fucking jaar, mense. Kan jy dit oorvertel? How incompetent must you not be as a government to have 365 days of uninterrupted state of disaster? How does that not expose you as a political party? Seriously. How do people after this go, you know what? I'm going to keep on voting for this party, you know? Whilst the rest of the world is moving on, we have had 365 days of uninterrupted state of disasters, where for a couple of months you weren't able to buy cigarettes, you weren't able to buy alcohol, you weren't able to go to the beach, you weren't able to go and exercise, you weren't able to jog, you weren't able to go to a park and walk your dogs. But hey, 2021, baby, 2021, and here we are still in the midst of a lockdown and a state of disaster that has been extended even more now. I think that we will probably, hopefully, get out of lockdown in spring. Maybe, if we're lucky. Because, I mean, this winter, they're not going to take any chances. We're definitely going to have it. So, I think if we are lucky, September, October, if we are lucky. If we are lucky. Mario Pistorius gave an extra 7 Rand. Thank you, Mario. You are officially in the lead with 57 Rand for this pillow. My personalized pillow. You see, it can look like that or it can look like that. Whatever you choose. So, yeah. Obviously, overseas donations are appreciated, but I'm not going to ship this overseas. So, this is for South Africans only. So, the top super chat tonight gets this very annoying pillow that I've had for many years in my videos that has got a Carter bite on it and a Kennedy couple of bites and I think a shit stain or two. A couple of shit stains. I think that's snot. I think that might be snot. Is it snot? No, it's not snot. It's dirty though. It can do with a wash. So yeah. Ibi Rippenham gave it $2 saying, I've been diagnosed with Rancid 19, a fart virus. Well, of course you have. Your farts smell delicious. Mel S gave a 35 Rand super chat saying, are you going to sign the subscriber pillow? Really? If people, like whoever the winner is, I will gladly sign it for them if that's what they want. But why would you want to ruin a very good, like, pillow? Like, so let me know, whoever wins, you can let me know if you want me to sign it, but hopefully not, because, like, I mean, the shit stain and the snort call there is already worth something. So, yeah, whoever wins it, if you want me to sign it, I will, but don't waste a good pillow. Bernice just came through with 140 Rand saying, go! So, obviously, Bernice is now seriously wanting this pillow with snort and potential shit on it. And then some Carter and Kenny bite marks over there. I'm just, you know, the last thing I want is for people to come and say, hey, I want a refund because there was marks on you. So, you know, I'm showing all the imperfections right now so that you don't, like, come and say, oh, we want a refund because of this or that. So, yeah. Let me just check what's going on here. Can you biki brighter or gaan vir my asseblief? Nee. Hoekom doen jy nou dit? Nee. Nee, jy gaan hoekom af? There we go. That's a little bit better. Thank you for the 140 Rand super chat, Bernice. Appreciate it. Oof. And then Tonic 69 came through with a 350 Rand super chat saying donate to Carter and Kenny. Well, thank you. You're currently in the lead for this pillow. Why? This pillow is not worth that much, people. This is a cock pillow. It's like the only thing I got from YouTube. Like, okay, well, other than the 100,000 plaque. I mean, I had to pay like, what was it, 3,000 rand to fly to Joburg to attend like a hoity-toity seminar on YouTube, and all I got was this cock pillow. Yeah. And I couldn't even live, or I couldn't even stream or record in YouTube's own like offices because they said you couldn't. But anyway, Tonic, thank you. You're in the lead with 350 Rand. That's greatly appreciated. Thank you very much. And then Ranir the Toy, or as I like to call it, the Twat, gave 100 Rand stripper chat. Shit, sorry. Thank you. Thank you very much. Greatly appreciate it. Thank you for the 100 Rand stripper chat, Ranir. I appreciate it. Anyway, back to the COVID-19 situation. So what has South Africa been through? Well, we've had 1.5 million coronavirus cases. We had 52,602 deaths. May all those souls rest in peace. And I really mean this. May everybody that has lost their lives, may their souls rest in peace. I mean that with all sincerity. There's been 1.47 million people that has recovered. And then, yeah, the total cases, we had that first wave, and then we had that second wave, and now every politician is talking about the third wave. The third wave is coming, people. Winter is coming. And then you can look there. I mean, the second wave was like obviously more severe. And now we, you know, people are looking at what's going on over here. Because let me just zoom in here if I can. Give me a second. There we go. People are getting worried because when was the April? No. That was the first case, wasn't it? The 200 and this is when we started with our lockdown, and then it was like you can't even, did they not report or what happened? Because the next one was April 18th, which is like so like the government. So March 27th is when we announced our lockdown, and on that date we had 243. So then like obviously that happened, and then the second wave at its peak we had 21,980, so 22,000 daily cases. And now I believe that we're less than the daily average. But hey, they need to instill fear, so that's potentially gonna happen. The third wave is coming. So yeah, we are actually lower now. The current infection rate is low, at its lowest point after the first wave, is it? Yeah, it's currently at its lowest point since the first wave kicked off. But everybody is talking about this third wave, and the Cyril and the ANC government potentially talking about instituting stage two, from what people are saying. So, yeah, I don't know. What do you think? Do you think that we're going to get a third wave? Do you guys think that we're going to get clapped by a third wave? Let me know, yes or no. If you think it's going to happen. Let me just make it a little bit brighter. There we go. I don't know. Based on the current statistics, I don't see a third wave coming, but I do see the government taking extra precautions because winter is coming. So I think that might be a possibility. But with that being said, I know that we obviously have an incompetent government. And I still don't think that the hospitals and everything is ready. So yeah. Tonic 69 gave another 35 Rand super chat for the pillow. Thank you very much. Saying, okay, if I win, donate to second place. Oh wow, that's very generous. So Tonic 69 says that if they are the top super chat, then they will donate it to the person who came second, who's currently Bernice with 140 Rand. So that's very generous. That's quite cool. Thank you for that. All of the subscribers to this channel should know this pillow, because this pillow is what YouTube gave me for attending one of their self-righteous seminars, and pretty much I think a box ticking exercise of hey, what we should do. By the way, if you want to see what's in here, maybe I shouldn't show you, because like maybe what's in here is like all 100 Rand notes, and somebody that gets this for like whatever they buy it for gets surprised with 100 Rand notes that folds it up all the way. So you just don't know. You don't know if this is filled with 100 Rand notes. No, it's not filled with 100 Rand notes. It's not. I'm telling you now. So yeah. Anyway, thank you so much for that, Tonic. It's appreciated. It's just filled with cushion. Well, you wouldn't know unless you buy a trans-conservative waifu. Who knows? Cheers, everybody. 1 year. Yes to the next year. Another year. What is like a 1 year anniversary? Is it like paper? Or what is paper? Like, I don't know what, like, is a 1 year anniversary like paper? I think it is. It's like, I've been in a 1 year anniversary with my government and I already want to file divorce papers. So then it's filled with 200 Rand notes. Good question, Carl. Maybe I've like actually filled it with 200 Rand notes and you just don't know it. Imagine how disappointing or disappointed people are going to be when they open it up and there's just a cushion. Italy is still on strict lockdown, about 400 deaths per day at the moment. Oh, that's crazy. That's crazy. Skull says Limpopo has 3,000 active cases, so in every municipality in Limpopo has a few cases. If they banned stuff, it would be dumb. Well, yeah, but I mean, what the government has been doing for the last year has been dumb, if I'm honest with you. So at the moment, the government has, what is like, let me see if I can find that, like, Democratic Alliance statistic here. Let's see if I can find it here quick. I just want to check if I can find it so I can show it to all of you. Where is it now? Where is it? Yeah. Yeah, here it is. Okay, I need to move this out the way. Okay, well, I'm in the way. Let me move myself out the way. There we go. So, COVID-19 vaccination tracker. The number of COVID-19 vaccines that have been administered as of the 22nd of March 2021 compared with the national government's target to achieve herd immunity by the end of the year is 40 million people vaccinated, right? As of the 22nd of March, 182,983 doses have been given. So 0.5% of the target. So at this rate, it will take 19.5 years to reach herd immunity in South Africa. So yeah, at the current rate, 19 years, it'll be COVID 40 by that time when we get there. So the government has, like, for the entire population of South Africa, they have they've given a vaccine to 0.03% of the population. 0.03%, I believe, of the population. Well done. 1 year. 1 year into lockdown, and 0.03% of the population has been given a vaccine. Slow clap. Flip, I will be in my mid-80s by then. Oh, sorry, Pat. You're not going to get it anytime soon. The vaccine, that is. You might get COVID. Renee says, perhaps that is why the power ship was contracted for 20 years. Exactly. And that those ships, I think it's like, what is it? Is it 21 billion or 210 billion rand? The contract for that. Carl says, you can't just calculate for right now. That's not how it works. Well, what do you mean? Let's have a look here quick. Let me bring the screen up here. Let's get the old calculator out, right? Let's bring the old calculator out. So let's be generous and say, let's actually be more generous. 190,000, right? Divided by 60 million equals, wait, is that 6 million? Yes, 60 million. Oh, wait, times 100. Is that right? Is that how you do it? Yeah, there we go. So 0.3% of the population. I speak under correction. I said 0.03. It's actual fact. 0.3% of the people have been given a vaccine. So it'll take like 19 and a half years to vaccinate everybody. Great, right? Great. An efficient government, ladies and gentlemen. An efficient government. Carl says you need to calculate it ramped up as the production of vaccines increase. Well, they've had more than 200,000 vaccines to give people. So K97 says miraculously we'll get the vaccine just before the 2024 elections. Well, yeah, I mean, but they've got to contest this election still in 2021, which I think they'll lose a lot of municipalities to. So, yeah. Badge 55 says, do you know about the Great Reset? And if you do, what do you think about it? Not too much. I'm not really that much into conspiracy theories. I just believe that, I mean, what would be the point of the Great Reset? I mean, I don't see why people would cause this devastation to create like a massive amount of poor people. Like, as how does that benefit people on taxes, etc. So yeah. Alfred One says, Ronaldo, a pink milk skommel sal no lekker wees. Nee. A chocolate milk skommel. Of a Brana and Pepsi. Cheers, everybody. Cheers. Dat hy val wyvel. I'm drinking too slow. The Bruce says, if you believe the vaccine will cure you from a virus created as a way to sway us from what's going on. Well, I mean, I think that there was a massive overreaction. I'll say that, though. I mean, the flu kills a lot of people. Just the normal flu. And yes, I think if so many people all of a sudden get sick at the same time, obviously it's going to overwhelm the, you know, the healthcare system, which is the fault of the ANC government, with all due respect, because they should make sure that the provincial hospitals are prepared. But it wasn't. And that was the fault of the government. DVD says, ain't it like America ain't it like America vaccinates 1.5 million people a month or so? Yeah, I think so. But remember, you're talking about a first world country and you're comparing them to the ANC. Now, I know that it's run by, you know, Sleepy Joe Biden, but still, I mean, even Sleepy Joe is a million times better than Cyril Ramaphosa and this ANC that we have. So, yeah, the Bruce says, really? Gates has bought up most of America's agricultural land. This just is up. Well, I don't know about that. I don't know. I don't know too much about it. Honestly, it doesn't affect me in any way. And I don't think it'll affect most of South Africa. So, yeah. Anyway, Tonic ZA is still in the lead for the subscriber pillow. Remember, top super chat tonight gets the pillow that I love so much. I love this pillow so much. I don't want to let it go. No, don't go, pillow. Don't go. Come back. Oh, here we go. Welcome back. Sick. So tonics in the lead were 385 rand, which is a decent amount of money for this pillow. Because I think this pillow's got some shit in on it, and then obviously some snorlos. Already? Are you just sitting here and waiting for daddy? Well, look how you are putting me to shame. Somebody came prepared. Hey? Somebody came prepared. Will you look at this? Will you look at this? Hey? Look at that. Are you so... I know that we said we're having a party, Carter. Why did you, like, really? Look at this. He came prepared. Like a real American gentleman. Look at that. Hey? We're going to sing the lockdown a little bit later. Not right now. But you've been in lockdown for so long that you'll dress up for anything. Look at him. He'll dress up for anything. Thank you, my boy. What do you... Are you tired already? We haven't even started the party yet. Whoop, whoop. But yeah, you dressed up nice, eh? Yes, sir. Ons kan jou uitvat. Look at that strik, does he? Like a real gentleman. Look at that. Hey? Mwah. Yes, my beautiful boy. Tell me he doesn't look like a gentleman. The American gentleman, the Boston Terrier, with his little strikdasi. I think you took this party thing way too serious, my boy. You didn't get the memo. There's something on your eye. You didn't get the memo. It's not a fancy dress, Carter. Damn it. It's not a fancy dress. Oh, do you want to chill here with daddy? Okay, you can chill here with daddy. There we go. You can sit here, and then when you have to sing your 1 year song, then we'll do it. There we go. He just wants to lie here. Okay. I think he didn't get the memo. He was like way too fancy for this party. Anyway, be sure to smash that like button. And if you are new to this channel, please be sure to subscribe. I know it'll be a miracle if YouTube has recommended this to somebody new. Because YouTube can't even show it to my current subscriber base. So, yeah. Carla says, puts you to shame. Cutie. I know, right? Pat says, he's adorable. Yeah. Party. Nice, folks. Be safe in South Africa. Have a great day, evening. Thank you, Ron. Appreciate it as always. Hope you are doing well over there in the States, my friend. Radishan says, can you see my subscription block? What color is it? It's yellow. It's yellow. Alfroan says, Ronaldo, ek het toe besluit om nie jou bure se huis te koop nie, hulle is nie normaal nie, daar is nie eers een loergaatjie of kamera na julle erf toe nie. Pff, I know, you would have spent too much money anyway. Thank God, I'm so happy to hear that. Kane says, Carter looks exactly like a well-dressed Jacob Zuma. Wow, that was an insult. That, sorry, Carter, you must close your ears for that one. That was completely uncalled for. Squidpaw Production says, Ronaldo, and congrats on 100k, bud. Finally and well-deserved. Well, thank you. Thank you very much. Yes, the plaque is there against the wall. I just hope it doesn't move off because it's stuck there with gorilla tape. Brenda says, Carter dresses for the job he wants, not the job he has. Ooh, like it. I like it. Lee says, ah, oh, bless Carter, too precious. Sis on you, Ronaldo, he's all dressed to the occasion. Well, I mean, he is black and white, so he's always like in a suit. And then he's got like, obviously, for those of you that didn't, he's like wanting to sleep here now. But look at this. Oh, sorry. I'm so sorry, gentlemen. There we go. You want to sing now and later? Show the people your dasi. There we go. Look at that. Yes, you want to sing now? No, let's keep it for later. It's a special occasion. You can sing for the people there with his little strikdasi. Why are you pulling forward? There we go. Now he doesn't want to show it off. He's embarrassed because he overdressed. Did you get my email? Yes, I did, Reditions. I don't respond to emails over the weekend, but I did get it. So yeah. Gorilla Glue Plus hair equals shampoo. Lol. Yeah, I heard about that. Is Carter not yorking tight? What? Yorking tight. I don't know what that means. The Bruce says, "No one is coming to rescue you. You are alone, and the sooner you realize that, the better you are." Yo, the Bruce, are you all right? I mean, I'm also having a dorp, but I'm not that depressed yet. Not that depressed. What's up? Show the people your dussy. There we go. Why does it keep on doing that? Yeah, it's because you do that. Put up your necky. There we go. There we go. Show the people. Show them. There we go. It does this bendy thing. There we go. There we go. Don't be embarrassed. You must like you stay classy, San Diego. You stay classy, San Diego. Good one. Good on. Go to your sister and then you can come back and sing Lock You Down just now. There we go. There we go. The Bruce is not depressed, just a realist. Yeah, but I mean, who's saying anybody needs saving? I'm not saying that. We know the government's not going to save us. So, yeah. Leon says, Ronaldo just laughed again about yesterday. Dirk, je bly nog by jou ma. South Africa, ja, je bly nog. Oh, that was hilarious. Oh, and yes, I did get a copyright notice and then I cut it out immediately. Immediately. Oh, that's hilarious. So, for those of you that didn't saw, like the comment section on any Dirk van der Westhuizen music video is the best. So, the one is on the song "Je bly nog by jou mama." So, the one comment says Dirk, "Je bly nog by jou mama," and then South Africa said, "Ja, en jy bly nog 'n." So, yeah, that was brilliant. Is Carter not talking tonight? Yes, he is. He'll be speaking in the last 5 minutes of the stream. Which reminds me, this pillow is up for grabs. Currently, Tonic 69's in the lead with 385 South African rongies. So, if you want to own this pillow, then you have to beat him. Or you have to hope that he chooses you. Or no, he chooses the second place, which is currently Bernice at 140 rand. So it's strategic tonight because Tonic 69 has said whoever comes in second can get this. And currently Tonic 69 is in the lead with 350 rand. And the second place is 140 rand. So yeah. Anyway, when do you guys think that the lockdown will end? I'm not talking about level 0.1.3.4.5.6.2. I'm talking about when there will be no state of disaster. When do you guys think that'll end? Squid Paw Production says Ronaldo will. Okay. If it is a criminal, let this be known. My final will and testament is in my safe if the robbers don't steal it. Will you accept PayPal for this for the pillow? Yes, but you have to live in South Africa. So you can use SnapScan, Zapper, PayPal, whatever. Just let me know. Just let me know so I can verify it by checking the email. Squid Paul says I can't super chat from Dubai. That's fine, but I'm not going to ship it to Dubai. I'll ship it to somebody in South Africa and then they can either ship it to you or you can get it when you're back in South Africa or something. But I'm not shipping it overseas because that it costs a car case. All right, it's a car case for health. So yeah, I'm willing to accept any type of a money transfer. You can even EFT me as long as the money reflects. I'm just joking. SnapScan, Zapper, PayPal, Bitcoin, and obviously the Super Chat. So yeah. Squid Paw Production says Ronaldo shipped to J Bay. Of course, I can either hand deliver it to J Bay when I go and visit my my mother and father-in-law. So yeah. The Bruce says Alfred want Allison ho op funny faces Mark done. Wow, what did Alfred want do? Ronaldo say for the hond, hy moenie for my bluff nie. Okay, that was a good one. That was a good one. Kuban says Ronaldo, wanneer die ANC seker is hulle kan weer 'n verkiesing wen en dit gaan nooit weer gebeur nie. Ja. The ANC is polling under 50%, ladies and gentlemen. This is literally like, this is where you need to tell your friend, your foe, and their dog that they need to go and register to go and vote this year, because every single vote is going to count. I mean, we've been in a lockdown now for 365 days. Today is the 1 year anniversary of lockdown. I remember like my first stream that I did, because I remember I did that 21 days lockdown stream with guests. And my first guest that I had was Prof. David Bullard. That was the first guest that I had. And then I ended it with Rikus, Radio Raps. Remember that? That was the first, because I had those lockdown streams day one until day 21 when we thought it was only going to be 3 weeks. And yet, fuck, imagine if I had to continue with that until now. It would have been like day 365 and I would have hosted my next door's neighbor's child or something. The Brew says, lol, I'm so glad you think voting still helps. Bless you. The Brew, it does. Because I know how the IEC system works. And, you know, unless you know more than I do, unless you've sat in more election campaigns and the vote counting and how it, it works, then I would listen. But up until that point, I'll say that, you know, perhaps you are giving the ANC and the IEC a little bit too much credit here. So, yeah. Aye, the Brew, I've explained this so many times before, but let me do it again very briefly. Every single voting station has party agents that count the votes. That gets signed off, a photo gets taken, and it gets correlated into the national amount or the provincial amount or the municipal amount, right? And the DA, the ANC, the EFF, and even the Freedom Front has at least, well, I know for a fact the DA covers every single voting station where they've got party agents. I know the ANC does too, and they have to agree on the voting station numbers in how it was counted, and that gets signed off by the IEC and the party agents, and that gets sent to the DA central hub that correlates and makes sure that that numbers is reflected when it goes onto the national leaderboard or when it goes on the provincial board or the municipal board. So all of that gets correlated. So yeah, you see the Brew, you're trolling a bit now, because those boxes actually gets opened up before the election and the boxes in the center of the room. And then if a box is full to the brim, then it gets sealed with a serial number that you can read before and after. And there's no physical way of adding a box or putting a different box. So the serial numbers on the boxes are written down. The boxes are shown to the party agents as being empty and all of these things. But okay, you keep on believing that. When I've actually sat through these things on many occasions, and I know exactly how it works. And it's not impossible, but it is near impossible to rig It is near impossible for the IEC to manipulate one or two voting stations. It is impossible for the IEC to manipulate most voting stations to sway the vote in the favor of one political party or another. So please stop spreading misinformation. Because if you actually knew how the process works, then you'll understand that what you are saying does not make sense. Because you're saying carton boxes. Well, yes, the carton boxes has actual serial numbers on it that get sealed. You didn't even know about that, which tells me something already. Anyway, Jay Valley says, I most definitely agree with Ronaldo here. I remember when we established the fact that the South African electoral process is more democratic than in Sweden. Well, it's very hard to manipulate it, which is the point. And remember, I mean, this was of people that didn't trust one another that set up this way of voting so that they can make sure that no, it can't be manipulated. I mean, our voting system is better than the rest of, well, at least we know for a fact, the United States, you know, just throwing it out there. Anyway, John Jarvis gave 150 Rand. Thank you so much, saying first shot. Well, John, your first shot is still 200 and, let me look here, 235 Rand short. Just throwing it out there. Because the leader currently is Tonic 69 with 385 Rand for their subscriber pillow. Just letting you know. If you're interested in the subscriber pillow, then you are like a little bit behind. And we're going to end in the next 10 minutes. Just letting you know. I don't know if a PayPal came through, by the way. People must let me know if I must check my PayPal. Let me just check if anything came through. No, I don't see anything. I don't see anything. So the super chats at the moment on the screen stands. Alfred One says, oh, come on, John Jarvis. The scientist says, Ronaldo, government might try to allow mail-in votes like in the USA. No, no, that won't slide. Anyway, I see 169 viewers. Thank you. 169. Nice. John says, did you forget what Sonic said? Yes, I did. I did, but I would have thought that, you know, you would want to settle for first place and not like a hand-me-down. But okay, whatever. If that is how you want to play it, then by all means, you can play it. I mean, you're playing it clever. Playing it very clever. Well done. I just thought that John Jarvis would have more money, you know, to actually win it outright. That comes out of my How to eBig Playbook, Chapter 7, page 345. Yeah. Squid Paw Production says, Ronaldo, check PayPal again, please, bud. Ooh, I like that. I like it. I like it a lot. Let me look here quick. I didn't get an email, but let me look. Let me see what is happening there. Oh, this process takes a while. Really? Are you going to give me a security challenge? Oh, my security challenge is I'm not a robot. Click here. Because a robot wouldn't know how to do that. What? Another security check? Really? Now you're asking me for a security code? Okay, that's clever. I won't lie. I won't lie. That was clever. Here we go. Jeez. What next? Do you want my blood type? Donor. I'm amazed that they don't want my blood type and everything else. Let's see here. All of that effort. I hope that you're not trolling. I just received... Oh, well. Okay, the time is different, but it's $50. Thank you. Wow. Payment from I'm not going to give your name out, but $50. I'm not lying. I promise you, you can trust me. If you want proof afterwards, I'll send it to you. But $50. So to be fair, $50 to ZAR is 751 Rand. There we go. 751 Rand. That is who the person is in the lead. Thank you for that, Squid Paw Productions. It's greatly appreciated. You are in the lead with 751 South African rankies. So what Tonic69 said has fallen out of the window. John Jarvis, yammer, yammer. But there we go. So Squid Paw Productions is in the lead. The Bruce says, to be fair, letter Kennedy. What? Ooh, the brew. You see, no, this is how a country should be run. My vrou het nou net my uitgekak om die charcoal sak in die garage te vat en ek het gespring. You see. Who runs the world, girls? Who runs the world, girls? Or woman, sorry. Oh, you can't say that anymore. Whatever you identify as. I identify as a gay dolphin. Because a gay dolphin is magnificent. Carla says, I love the cushion, but I'm broke after last night's auction. And I spent my husband's money on that auction. Completely understand, Carla. I know it's too many auctions, but like somebody asked that I please auction this off. So yeah, obviously currently 751 Rand for this pillow that has got a shit stain, I believe, and a snort stain on it. And it's got a Carter bite and a couple of Kennedy bites. So Squid Ball Productions is currently in the lead. And there's 1 minute left. So 1 minute. If you can beat or want to beat, you've got 1 minute to do so. Grant Rothman says Squid in Dubai, Ronaldo. He said that he would ship it to Jeffreys Bay. So yeah. Skulls says, asked you a question, please answer. Okay, Skulls. Do you think there's people that double voted at different voting stations, or do you think it's fake news? Because I remember there was videos on social media. It's definitely fake news because firstly, you have to provide your ID. It gets scanned and that gets updated automatically. And if that system loses connection, then it'll say that it's lost connection and that they can't continue the vote until the connection is restored. So that updates the system immediately, and they also do the test by showing it. So they scan an ID, and if they scan the ID again, then obviously that'll affect it. Anyway, we're going to do the locky down, and then after that the auction is officially done. So if you would like to win this pillow, then 751 Rand is what you have to put in to beat it. Currently, Squid Paw Productions is in the lead with 751. Come on, boy. You're dressed for the occasion. You dressed so nicely for this occasion with your strakdasi. There we go. Come and sing for the people. There we go. There we go. Okay. La 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 la. La 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 la. Key down. 365 days, the 1 year anniversary of Loki Down. That was a good one. You're doing it very classy tonight with your strakdasi, I have to say. Loki. Loki Down. 365 days of Loki Down. I like the strakdasi actually works when he puts his head back like that. Oh, sorry. Are you right? Okay. Wim Siddle, it has been one fucking year of Loki Down. 365 days of Loki Down. Je gaat voor Loki Down. 1 year. 1 year of Loki Down. That's completely unacceptable. What do you think of Wim Settle? Yeah, I think so too. Mwah. Thank you, my beautiful boy, for singing Loki Down, I believe, for 365 days. Thank you. Mwah. I really do appreciate it. Thank you so much. It's greatly appreciated. Thank you very much. And I think everybody in the chat will thank you too for that. Thank you. Thank you, Carter. And you dressed beautifully tonight, eh? We'll give you some dog champagne. Doy Instant Donor. I just saw Yanni give 1,500 Rand. Yo, that is crazy. That's crazy. Yanni really wants the subscriber pillow. It's got snort and cuck on it, Yanni. And you want the subscriber pillow. Wow, well done. Okay, well, I think it's officially done because I said after Carter sings. So congratulations, Yanni van der Walt, with your 1,500 Rand stripper chat. Thank you. And don't worry, Squid Paw Productions, for your efforts and your donation, I will send you a tack mat. I hope that that is like a kind of a thank you second place. So thank you very much for your generous PayPal donation. It's greatly appreciated. So if you are happy with that, which I'm assuming you will be, Squid Paw Productions, then I will send you a tech mat to the Jeffrey's address, if that's fine with you. So yeah. Anyway, wow, Yanni, you really want this snort and cock. I'm not washing this, by the way. Like, Reese can wash it. But thank you. Wow, that is nice. That is the first time in a long time I'm seeing a red super chat. Yo. And yeah, okay. I know Yanni actually just bought this to see if they were 200 rands. No, sorry. It's just a cushion. Do you want your money back guarantee? Well, guess what? There isn't any. This isn't Morkel's, your 2-year guarantee store, okay? This is like, gotcha, okay? It's like a scam, and I just got you. Well, well done. Anyway, seriously though, thank you, Yanni. That's insane. 1,500 rand for a pillow. You almost paid as much as what I paid for my airfare ticket to go and get this. That's crazy. Yanni says, ah, fuck, ek het gedink daar is geld in. sorry, daar is ie. Anyway, thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, for tuning in. It's greatly appreciated. Wow, thank you for all the super chats. I really do appreciate it. Let me just run through it. Alfredwant, Ursula, Mario, Ibi Rippenham, Mel S, Trans, Conservative Waifu, Bernice, Tonic, Renier de Toy, John Jarvis, and Yanni van der Walt, and then obviously Squidpaw Productions. Thank you very much. Squidpaw says, what will you send me? A tech mat. It's a doormat that says tech on it. So that is what I'll send you. So pop me an email to info@techclothing.com with your name, surname, address, contact number, and obviously proof that you are who you say you are. So I need some proof. Yanni knows it already. I've got Yanni's address, so I'll sort it out with Yanni. But yeah, Yanni, just pop me an email anyway, or send Lauren a WhatsApp, please, because I'm going to forget. But yeah, thank you very much, Yanni, for that insane super chat. It's greatly appreciated. And yeah, ladies and gentlemen, 1 year under lockdown. Let's hope that the government gets voted out, irrespective of whether they end lockdown tomorrow or not. We can't go on with this cuck. We can't have an incompetent government that still runs this country. Our economy's in the shitter. Our healthcare is in the shitter. There are people suffering daily. And yet, you know, we can't continue like this, because then eventually everything that we have as hardworking individuals will be for nothing. Because if the government collapses and the country collapses, then our money turns into Zimbabwean currencies, which, as we know, is nothing. So yeah. Carla says the doormat is great for family arriving. Like some family, I suppose. Yanni says, Ronaldo, thanks, bud. And thanks for keeping us entertained and informed. Only a pleasure, Yanni. And thank you for the support, not just financially, which you guys have been doing, which is great. But thank you for just being who you guys are. I mean, Yanni and Reese are absolute legends. We speak quite often. Fantastic human beings and very generous. Not just on my channel, not just financially, but also with just having open hearts. So thank you for and generous hearts. Thank you for what you guys are doing for the community. It's greatly appreciated. Anyway, thank you everybody for tuning in, and happy 1 year anniversary of probably the anniversary that nobody really wants to celebrate. And hopefully we won't be here on the 27th of March 2022 to celebrate the 2 year anniversary of the lockdown, because that'll be an absolute travesty. So yeah, thank you so much for tuning in. Be sure to smash that like button, everybody. I see that we haven't even hit 100 likes. So the least that you can do is smash that like button. So be sure to smash that like button, and please also be sure to subscribe. And I think even Kenny wants to say hello. Come on, baby girl. Come to daddy. Come. Yeah. Come to daddy. Come. There we go. Even Kenny wants to say hello. Say hello to everybody. Where's your strikdasi? Hey? Don't you have a strikdasi on? Kenny says hello. Says hello, Kenny. Mm. What do you think, Kenny? Oh, can you go? She's the most beautiful Boston girl in the world. Are you going to sing for us? Are you going to sing? If I try, will you sing a bit? Lucky down, lucky down. Carter's in the back, so I think he'll start singing and then hopefully that'll trigger her. Let's see her quick. Lucky down, 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 lucky down. Yeah, she did it. Nanzuenya. She did it. Yes, the 1 year anniversary, ladies and gentlemen. Kenny sang the Locky Down with Carter. Can you believe it? Can you believe it? That is time. What? Celebrate good times. Come on. Oh, I got that completely out of celebrate good times. Come on. Wait. I think that's what. Celebrate good times. Yeah. Yeah. Celebrate good times. Yeah. Okay. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for tuning in. Really appreciate it. Enjoy your dop and chop. Have a lucky evening. And I will see you tomorrow night for day 366 under the lockdown. Have a lucky evening. Till later. Cheers and peace out.
You don't even know me, but every time you see me, you say I'm in my massacre. You don't even know me, but every time you see me, you say I'm in my massacre. I'm in my massacre. You don't even know me, but every time you see me, you say I'm in my massacre. I'm in my massacre.